How do you reconcile a lot of the Hindu exclusivists who say like only Vishnu or only Shiva is the true deity with people who are pluralistic or accept everything?
You see, Hinduism has been pluralistic since very ancient times. But we had skirmishes, we had problems. About 1,000, 2,000 years ago, there was a lot of fighting between the Vaishnavites and the Shaivites in South India. They were killing each other, just as you hear now the Sunnis and Shias, you know, blowing each other up. We had similar issues a few thousand years back in India as well. So some of these movements which are kind of focused or polarized on the idea of God as Shiva or God as Vishnu would have a problem with each other. They said, we alone are right, how dare they say their God is better than ours or higher than us. So there was fighting. The only thing is we've matured enough to be able to live side by side with each other without feeling compromised, without having to thump each other. So we have matured, India has matured. So for the last thousand years, I would say, we've been able to live peacefully with each other, people of variety of different faith, you know, belief systems, live together in the spirit of pluralism. And yet there are factions even in modern India, with modern times, where you have certain movements making exclusivist claims about their own particular Godhead. Our answer as an inclusivist is this: if you love God as whatever, good for you, carry on, but stop bothering us. We have got our own way of thinking about religion and spirituality, which God or which personality attracts is our choice. You got it good, you found your own mentor, you found your Godhead, go to it, but stop bothering us. So don't impose your view on us. We wish you well. We tell the people of other religion, whichever particular God appeals to you, or no God in Buddhism, if that is your way of unfolding your human condition, go for it. We are not here to stop you, but don't impose yourself on me. This is the breadth of vision of pluralism. But the thing is this. People sometimes ask me, Mr. Lakhani, you are a pluralist. I say, yes. So you are inclusive. He said, yes. He said, can you be so inclusivist that you even include the exclusivist movement within your group? I said, this is a contradiction in terms. Contradiction in terms. Now the little young lady is telling me, I already know the answer. I know you know the answer. You know it better than me. But this is the important. Pluralism is difficult. And we had difficult times, but we have now matured. So modern India doesn't have a problem, but we had problems in the past.